Amazon PPC Dayparting. Many Amazon sellers use different third-party tools or software to manage their PPC campaigns just because the software adjusts the bids every hour, which is so tough for a human being. But the fact is that the software is costly, especially for lower range or mid-range sellers. As a result, they fear to purchase the software for managing their PPC campaigns. Well, there is a good news for Amazon sellers that Amazon recently launched PPC Dayparting into the advertising console. You do not need to hire any software or third-party tools for managing your PPC. Amazon itself now gives you the hourly-based report for your advertising campaigns. Previously, we published a video on this topic where we showed how you can download this report and what data they actually gives you on this report. In today's video, I am going to discuss how you can analyze this report and make informed decisions for your advertising campaigns. Also, what time frame you should focus more on your advertising campaigns and how you can set the bidding strategy hourly basis. This is Hasan from Ecomclips and let's start today's topic. Well, this is the report that you can download from the advertising console. Also, I have prepared a separate report. Let me show you. This is the report that I have organized from the previous one, and I mainly segmented some time frame here, like this one, from 12 a.m. to 4 a.m. night and 5 a.m. morning to 2 p.m. and then again another segment 3 p.m. to 8 p.m. and the last one 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. Let me discuss you why I have segmented this time frame. Okay, so let me show you the time frame like 12 a.m. to 4 a.m. mainly at night. I have spent around $364 and in returns I got 2k sales. Also, my organic sales is around 3k, so my total sales is above 5k with 18% ACoS and 6.96% TACoS. And the next time frame is like morning 5 a.m. to 2 p.m. So around this time I have spent almost 3k in PPC. And in returns in PPC, I got around 18k sales. My organic sales is 27k. So total around 45k sales. And my ACoS is 15% with 6.29% TACoS. Okay, then next time frame, I have picked 3 p.m. to 8 p.m. So around this time, my advertising spend is 1.5k with almost 10k PPC sales and 29k organic sales. So total it's almost 40k sales with 15% ACoS. Here my TACoS is so cool, around 3.86%. So the last time frame 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. around this time I have spent only $80 with 625 sales in PPC and my organic sales is almost 10k. So in total, I got around 10k sales with 12% ACoS and my TACoS is so cool, 0.79%. Okay, so from this report, I have analyzed some things. So my first observation is that here you can see that around this time frame is 5 a.m. to 2 p.m. So around this time, my spend is almost 3k. And also my total sales is 45k, but after that segment mainly 3 p.m. to 8 p.m. so this time my advertising spend is only 1.5k, but my organic sales is pretty well, even better than the previous segment. So my first observation is here, my advertising campaigns mainly getting out of budget around this time, and that is why my advertising spend was lower, but the overall performance was pretty good. So I think I need to put more focus on this time. For example, like maybe I can increase the budget of some of the advertising campaigns so that they will not go out of budget and they can spend and also help increase the overall sales. Okay, my next observation is like last segment 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. here you can see that I have spent only $80. So that means my most of the advertising campaigns was getting out of budget or maybe finished their budget. And that is why they didn't get enough budget for spending. But Also, that time my overall sales was good. So if I could put a particular budget, let's say like maybe 200 budget, if I could put, my result was far better than the previous time. So that's the point I maybe missed out. So my next observation is that based on this report, I can set different bidding strategy. Like for this segment, I can set a different bidding strategy. Like maybe I can increase my bids maybe 10 to 15%. And for the next segment, I can also set another bidding strategy. So these are the benefits that I can get from these hourly reports. So now let's fix my observation. My first observation was I need to increase my advertising budget for some particular time. And my second observation was I can say different bidding strategy for particular time frame. So let's start this. Let me go to the advertising campaign and I'm opening this one. So from here you can see the budget rules. Let me open it. So right now you can see that my daily budget is $20 for this campaign. So I can add a new budget rule. So mainly it works like you can set a budget rule like for some particular time frame or particular period, you can increase your campaign's level daily budget so that it will not go out of budget. Based on the performance, you can set this. Also based on the time frame, you can set this. Like if you set the time frame, for example, like maybe 6 p.m. to 9 p.m., you want to increase your budget. So it will automatically raise the budget that you set. And also you can set maybe based on the performance, like if your advertising ROAS above 4, you can increase the budget automatically around 25% or whatever you set it. Okay, so let me set my rule name. For example, like peak time. Let's say 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. And there are two types. One is schedule and another one is performance. What I said, if you set the schedule, then you need to like set the time frame or maybe date range. But if you set the performance, then it will work based on the performance like ROAS, ACoS, CTR, CVR, this way. Okay, so let's, for my purpose, I need to set the schedule time. So let's click on schedule. So here for the date range, you can see that there are two options. One is recommended events. For example, like we have Black Friday and also we have some upcoming events like Cyber Monday, Christmas season. That time you can set different date range. For example, let's say if you select the recommended events, you can select some upcoming events like our next event is Black Friday. So it will automatically be chosen. But for me, I want to set the custom date range. So from here, I can set the start time and also the end time. So the start date, it will be okay. And I do not want to set any end date. And for the recurrence, it will be 2, daily or weekly. So I am going to set daily. And this is the updated part, hours of the day. So that means each day you can set a different time frame when you want to increase the budget. So let me choose a start and end date. Sorry, end time. Okay, the start time will be 7 p.m. and end time 11 p.m. Oh, sorry, 9 p.m. For 2 hours, I can increase the budget. Let's say 35%. Okay, so my daily budget was $20 and after increasing 35% daily budget, it will be 27. Let me increase more. 75%. Okay, so it will be 35. Okay, so let's click on the add budget rule. And this budget rule is already set. Now let's go to the campaign setting. Oh, let me show you. Here you can see that my budget rule is already applied. Now let's go to the campaign setting. And from the campaign bidding strategy, here you are seeing that there are two options. One is rule-based bidding and another one is other bidding strategies. So the rule-based bidding is almost same as budget rule. You can increase your bids based on the performance. Like if the ROAS is above 4, then you can increase the bid maybe some percentage. So Amazon will automatically adjust the bid accordingly until you have above 4 ROAS. The next option is other bidding strategies. And here is the new one with schedule rules. So right now I don't have any rules. I need to add the schedule rule from here. Click on add schedule rule. So here you can see the similar page as I showed you before for the budget rule. So let me skip the date range for now because I want to set this as it is now. For the recurrence, it will be daily, and hours of the day I will choose a different time frame. So let's say like for start with 6 a.m. and in time will be 6 p.m. and in time will be 9 p.m. and I wanna increase my bid with, let's say, 23%. Oh, one thing you can see from here, there is no option to reduce the bid rate. You can't say, even if you select minus 15%, it won't work. So Amazon only kept the option to increase your bids, not decrease your bids. Okay, so let's select 23% and let me set the rule name according to the time frame, 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. and click on add rule. So I have already set one add rule, and I also want to select another add rule. So let's again click on the add schedule and again select, choose start and end date and select the time. So it will be 9 p.m. and in time will be 11 p.m. Okay, this time I want to increase my bids 35% and set the at rule 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. and select add rule. So I have said two different bidding strategy for different time frame. One is 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. and another one is 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. Now you need to focus and you need to remember one thing, that you can see that I have already set one budget rule for this campaign, and I have already set the keywords level bids rate. And also here I have set another bidding strategy for 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. I want to increase my budget 23%. So for your case, if you have also placement, so that you need to keep in mind that your bid rate will be increased higher and higher if you set these types of bidding strategy several times. So for example, if you have top of search placement, maybe 10%. So let's say if any keyword have $1 bid rate, the keyword can be increased up to 10% as it has already 10% top of search placement. And now, as you have said, 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. increased by 23%. So that 23 plus 10, 33%. So the keyword can increase the bids up to 33%. So you need to keep in mind these things while you adjust your bids rate, so that it will not affect your overall ACoS. Well, this is how you can analyze your hourly based report, and also based on this report you can set different bidding strategy for a particular time. Anyway, before ending the video, I am gonna suggest you one more thing. You know, Q4 is the peak time for any sellers, and around this time you're gonna have so many events like Black Friday, Cyber Monday, Thanksgiving, Christmas, and so many events. So around this time you're gonna have a higher sales for your items. So you need to focus more both on your management part and also the PPC part, because you know PPC is the crucial part for your business. So you need to focus more on your advertising campaigns and adjust the campaigns accordingly. If you need any help with your advertising account, please email us at info@ecomclips.com with this video reference. Also, please subscribe to our channel Ecomclips and share this video with others. Thanks for watching this video. Take care.